Thank you. Actually, now it's time to have a look back at some of the other favourite characters.
All right.
The Robinson family, as brought by the very beautiful Anne in Neighbours.
Hi, I'm Brooke, although you probably know me better as Anne Wilkinson. Everyone else is working really hard at the moment, but I thought I'd take a sneaky break and take you behind the scenes at Neighbours.
Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours with a little understanding. You can find the perfect...
Of course, I live here at number 26 with my family. Although when Neighbours first hit your screens way back in October 1986, it was one of the soap's most endurable and memorable families that live behind the store.
Hello, Jim Robinson.
Oh, Lucy, stop trying to carry on. What's happening in this house? Darling, what's wrong? Lucy, go and get Clyde quickly.
I believe the best man lives here.
Paul, what happened? Where's Terry?
She's gone.
Who did this to you?
What's this?
A peace offering.
Thank you.
Dad, I don't mean to interfere.
I love you.
You do?
Ambulance. 30 Ramsey Street, Erinsborough.
Madge, Harold and their foster son Paul live here now. But way back when Neighbours was the newest drama on the box, this was known as the Ramsey House. Yep, number 24. And it was actually the first house that we saw all of 3,000 episodes ago.
Raymond Buck's parties. It's Max. Now listen, what are you going to do about them bloody neighbours of yours?
Ah, the rough and ready Ramseys. Now, the story of the Robinson family continues right here at this window, where one of the most memorable relationships in the history of television was to begin. Scott and Charlene eventually became Mr. and Mrs. Robinson, although the path of true love never runs smooth, and never more so than in soap opera land.
Everything between us is over.
Paul, put it down, please. Please, Paul, I love you.
Where was your trust, Anne?
That's not the way to find love with Scott.
I don't think anyone can love me.
I thought you might be waiting for your mystery girlfriend.
No.
You know, famous Miss Invisible.
You stop it. Sarcasm isn't your best thing.
Come here, you.
Oh, I feel such a blasted fool. Right, though, I wish I wasn't so damn set in my ways.
Does this mean that you're not going to do the washing up?
Here I am in number 30. Turdy, Joel and Lance are out, but I'm sure the boys won't mind if I help myself. This reminiscing is hungry business. Of course, the Robinsons have had their fair share of trials over the last 15 years, and it wasn't just Scott and Charlene who saw some big love action.
By the authority vested in me, I now pronounce you man and wife.
joining together in marriage of Ruth and Philip.
Congratulations to you both.
A good wedding. We've certainly had a few of those on Neighbours. Now, no trip down Neighbours memory lane could be complete without matriarch to the Robinson family and friend and comforting ear to all those who've walked through these doors. Helen Daniels.
Oh, Daphne. Oh, if only you could laugh. If only you could hear what I'm saying.
One, two, three.
Of course you're forgiven. When have I ever been able to stay angry with you for long?
Action stations!
Oh, action stations!
The wonderful Anne Hattie, who sadly died earlier this year. She was an inspiration to all of us and is dearly missed. Well, that concludes our tour of the lives, loves and liaisons of the Robinsons. Hope you enjoyed it. I hope it brought back some great memories. And here's to another 15 years here in Ramsay Street.
Thank you very much, Brooke.